In this video, I'm going to be sharing with you my favorite passing scheme in Madden 21 for a 2x2 style, 3x1 style of offense. What's up, guys? My name is Cody, and I want to thank you for taking the time to watch this video. Now, if this is your first time visiting my channel is all about helping people become the best Madden player that they could possibly become. And so if you're looking to get better at this game, I want to encourage you to click the subscribe button at the bottom right-hand corner of your screen. It is completely free to subscribe, and it just allows you to be able to stay up to date with the latest tips and the latest strategies in the Madden community. Now, if you're new to the channel, like I said, it's completely free to subscribe. We do videos every day about Madden 21, but what we're talking about in today's video is the gun wide off trips pats. This can also be called the U-trips. It's what it was formerly called in Madden in previous years. But in today's video, we're talking specifically about this play here, the tight end whip. Now, the beauty of the U-trips is this is an offense that really centers around, what I would tell you is it centers around two things. It centers around motion snapping, but it also centers around what I would say is just very solid spacing. It's very similar. It's kind of almost like running gun doubles, really. If you think about it, you're kind of running trips. At the same time, you're running doubles because of how much motion you're going to use. And so we're going to be breaking down the play tight end whip today. This is one of my favorite concepts just for simply working the ball down the field. And I actually have a complete U-trips offensive guide. And if you want to get my full U-trips offensive guide, I'm going to leave a link to that in the description. I just released it, and it's just $10 for the U-trips offense. So if you want to learn everything that I know about U-trips in Madden 21, you can get the full ebook for just 10 bucks. I'm going to leave a link for you in the description of this video. But the play we're going to be going over today is tight end whip. Now, tight end whip is the play of choice today, and the way that we're going to run this play is we are going to take that circle receiver, and this is what's really important whenever you run U-trips. If you notice, the square receiver has a very unique little post route. You'll see that I can smart route it, and it's going to go down. It's going to be about a 5-yard, you know, kind of quick snap type thing. You know, you can do the same thing with the circle receiver. If you notice the circle receiver, I can smart route him as well, and he's going to go at a certain depth. And so the point is simply that the post routes are really what is so special, in my opinion, about this amazing offense. And so we're going to start with man coverage here today. But what we're going to do as far as our route combination is I'm going to take the triangle receiver, and if I were to have like a wish is that I could have backfield master or hot route master within this offense would make it even better than it already is. But basically, you just want to put your running back on a wheel route or a swing pass to the left side. If you have hot route master, I would suggest putting him on a flat route. But for this example, we're going to put him on a little wheel route. The next thing that we're going to do is we're going to take the circle receiver, which in this case is Marquez Valdes-Scantling, and we are going to put him on a little check down curl route. As you can see right there, he's going to go on just a very simple check down type of curl route. And then the last thing that we're going to do is we're going to take our tight end, and we are going to streak him right up the vertical seams. As you can see, this is going to create a very interesting little levels concept is basically what we're creating. And we're going to motion that R1 receiver to the left side, and we're going to snap him basically right before he sets his feet, as you can see right there. And against man coverage, that R1 receiver is going to be absolute money, as you can see right there. Very consistent, and he very simply just beats the man coverage. That's exactly what he does, and that's exactly what he's supposed to do. The next read on this play, once you look to that R1 receiver, you know, the natural next progression that you're really looking for is the square receiver. And as you can see right there, that square receiver, if I would have clicked onto him, he would have been very effective against man-to-man coverage. Now, one of the things is, like, if you know that they are running a lot of man-to-man coverage on you, then what I would encourage you to do is snap the ball right here. And the reason why is just because you're going to get both of those receivers unbumpable, and they're going to be able to really easily be able to beat that coverage. Now, the next thing that you want to look for is really more of a zone beater, but I'm going to check down into the Mike Blitz 3 here. We're going to run a little bit of Mabel coverage. And really what you're going to notice from this concept of this passing system is it's very interesting how good this really is against cover 3 Mabel. You see that I can wait on this. The beauty of that square receiver is you can wait on him again, and he is a multi-window route. What I mean by that is you can throw that early, you can throw that medium, and you can also throw that late. And that's the beauty of this. You can throw it at multiple different points, and he is going to get very consistently open for you. The same is also true of this R1 receiver. But as you can see, if they're playing underneath coverage on that R1 receiver, then you're just going to chuck it up to the post route. The next thing that I want to go over with you in this video is I want to go over this little tight end streak. Now, this tight end streak, if they're playing, you know, disciplined defense, it's very unlikely that you're going to want to hit that tight end streak. But if they're not playing smart, you can just kind of quickly slice that up the seam, especially if you have a gunslinger type of quarterback. That's what makes gunslinger such an important ability, and that's why we pretty much have it on every quarterback that I would ever use in Madden 21. The same is also true of Tampa 2. You're going to see that, you know, you have a lot of room, a lot of windows, a lot of opportunity that you can hit. The beauty of this specific offense is it does a brilliant job at attacking the entire field. It really does make the defense have to respect the entire field. And so that's what makes this offense so special. And if you want to get my full U-Trips offensive guide, I'm going to leave a link in the description that you can get that for just 10 bucks right now. Fully available. Walks you through everything you need to know about the U-Trips. So if you want to get that, that's going to be available in the description. If you have any questions about this video, feel free to text me. My cell phone number is 208-218-6900. Thanks for your time. I hope you enjoyed the video. And like I said, if you want to get my full U-Trips offensive ebook, it is down below for just 10 bucks.